Salam Namaste Sasriyakal, welcome to my channel Wonders Lost Veggies, and this is Colombo. Well, the last video got really long, so I made this in two parts. This is day 3 in Colombo, and this is what I did the whole day. Went to the temple, explored the area. Forget to see the last video. How I went to the National Museum of Colombo and then Velavad Beach, and it was so beautiful over there, just playing around the sun near the sand. And obviously there was this Velavad market, and the train crosses from there. You can see the train track. The most often thing you'll see in any market would be the orange watermelon, so you must try it over here. It's very healthy. I did the next after being in the beach for so long, so I just wanted to have something cold. And so I ended up taking a tuk-tuk towards this Buddha temple, Gangaramanaya temple. And because there's no direct bus, there was like 155 and then 138, I had to change. So I ended up taking tuk-tuk, and he took about 200 Sri Lankan rupees. This temple is open Monday to Sunday, 6 a.m. till 10 p.m. This is one of the oldest Buddhist temple in Colombo. Suma gate. Inside this Buddhist temple, there is a beautiful gallery dedicated for it, and this temple, and then there is another Buddha river temple actually. That's just beside there, like walking distance. You can visit that. The best time to visit is in the evening because it lights up and it looks beautiful in the night because it's in the seaside. Beside that, there is this Gangaram, Seema, Malayaka, which is just walking distance from there. And the best time to visit both of these temples are in the evening. That's why I came in the evening, because both of them are too nearby to miss it. And then there are lights on. Gangaramanaya temple is not only the most beautiful but the most iconic Buddhist temple in Sri Lanka today. It's a century old construction, built in 19th century. It's more than a century's old temple. But however, today it still is constructed, and it doesn't surprise you, stop surprising tourists and devotees. The pathways and the doors that lead into the main sanctuary contains integrated carving sculptures that are simply breathtaking. Main premises of this place house has a large statue of Buddha, and the ceiling of the temple tells the tales of life. Shouldn't miss the replica of Borobudur, centrally Java in Indonesia, the house of the largest Buddhist temple in the world. This temple house is a perfect imitation of that temple. This perfect replica is asymmetrical, pleasured, and is one of the finest examples of South Asian architecture. Miss out to check this Eric chamber. It's beautiful carvings, and it's so mesmerizing to just look at them, you know. Even if you're not religious yourself, this place is so nice and serene vibe. You'll feel calm and, you know. enormous, beautiful Buddha, the secret fig tree, which is believed to be the place where Buddha gained enlightenment. Hence, it is an important historical and cultural site of devotees of Buddhism.
ये वाली ये मर्सिडीज है ना, ये सारा विंटेज सामान ही रखा है, ये दे आर रेनोवेटिंग, आई थिंक दैट्स द रीजन इट्स केप्ट लाइक दिस.
Temple sports exceptionally beautiful architect and is located in the banks of the famous lake Bira. Seema, Malayaka. This place is designed by the most famous architect of Sri Lanka, Georgifu Bava. It is essentially an assembly place of the monks of the temple and is located in the middle of Bira Lake. The place was built in 1979 and features various architects and famous South Asian cultures. And it's a lovely atmosphere, minimalistic colors, scenic vibes makes this place a lovely destination and a place to go to refuse from hustle and bustle of tourist crowd.
आपका आ गया शैंग्रीला द मॉल एंड ऑपोजिट दिस गेल बीच. लेट्स सी व्हाट ऑल दे आर सेलिंग. दिस इज लाइक मुंबई, मुंबई चपाटी. दिस इज काइट ओनली आई थिंक. दिस इज चिप्स.
This was my whole day in Colombo, visiting all over. I'm super tired. I'm just gonna sleep now. And I'll just request you to please like my video. It'll mean a lot to me. Thank you so much. Bye. Good night.